yellow at some point.
Man, she is a fly.
Not a fly, is fly. She's fly.
Well, I just wish I knew what to do to get a girl like her.
Easy. Be a guy like him.
In high school, you learned that the type of girl you are determines the type of guy you go out with. Nerdy girls hang out with nerdy guys. Smart girls hang out with smart guys. And dumb girls hang out with jocks.
Ladies.
And then there are the girls that didn't hang out with anybody and the guys that made fun of them. We were those guys. And she was that girl.
Man, look at that. She looks like her family gave the baby back and kept the stork.
Her name is Kelly, but everybody calls her Big Bird.
Hey, Big Bird.
You, Big Bird?
What's up, Big Bird?
I wonder what would have to go wrong for you to end up with a girl like that.
It's like being on the Planet of the Apes and all the apes said no.
I didn't have anything against Big Bird, and unfortunately for me, she didn't have anything against me either.
You're Chris, right?
Yeah.
I've seen you around, and I really think you're kind of cute. Do you want to hang out sometime?
No.
Sure.
Where's an ape when you need one? While Big Bird was trying to get with me, Greg was trying to get the lowdown.
Dude, did I see you talking to Big Bird yesterday?
Shh. Yeah, she asked me out.
She's like the goofiest girl this side of Roseanne, Rosanna Dana. What'd you say?
I told her yeah.
Why?
Because she asked. A girl doesn't ask me out all the time.
Yeah, that's the beauty of the situation. You had a chance to boost your low self-esteem by turning someone else down for a change.
Yeah, but when the girl asks, you just don't say no. Plus, my dad said never to hurt a girl's feelings. Besides, they don't take rejection well.
How are they gonna learn if they don't get any practice?
Attractive girls don't take rejection well. Girls like Big Bird, they're used to it.
You know what, fine, it's done. I'm gonna go out with her once. Trust me, I'm gonna make sure we don't have fun, so she doesn't wanna go out again.
I usually did that without trying. While I was betting I could get rid of Big Bird, Vanessa was betting big on the Jets.
Here you go. Sorry it took so long.
5 weeks. You should be sorry. You should have saved your money. I told you the Jets were gonna win.
Vanessa, you gonna get enough of this gambling. I keep trying to tell you.
Oh, this is a sure thing. The New York Jets have been on a winning streak like you've never seen.
They just got lucky. I'll bet you they don't win next week.
The Giants play the Jets?
No, they just both on winning streaks.
Wait a minute. This is the dumbest thing I ever heard. Your team is winning, and your team is winning, but you both figure out a way to lose money on it.
Well, all I know is the Giants are gonna lose before the Jets.
I'll tell you what. If the Giants lose before the Jets, the barbershop will pay for you ladies to have a night out on the town.
Uh-oh. That's not good. Well, start saving.
What if we win?
That is not going to happen.
Since it's not gonna happen, say anything. Buy everybody a new car. Cook dinner for all the men for a month. Better yet, go out with kill moves.
Oh, all right, little Miss Naysayer. I'll do that. If we lose, I'll go out with kill moves. Mm.
While Vanessa bet on the Jets, I had a date with a Giant.
Hey, Chris. Is that what you had on earlier?
No, I had an accident and I needed to change.
An accident? What happened?
Oh, I didn't make it to the bathroom in time, so I had to get some of them lost and found.
Wow, that's crazy. It looks good on you, though. It makes you look edgy.
Even though my bad clothes didn't seem to work, there was more bad stuff to come. Bad food.
Never heard of this place.
Yeah, everything they serve is from stuff that other people didn't finish eating.
After the bad food, there was a bad movie.
What's this called?
Leonard Part 5, Nipsey Russell's best movie. They're doing a sequel with Bill Cosby.
After the bad movie, we took a bad walk.
You little dude on a date. Let me hold all your money.
No! The only date worse than me was Phil Spector. While I was running for my life, Vanessa was running her game down.
Listen up now, everybody. Now, we all in this together. So if we're gonna win this thing, then we gotta get our mojo working.
Mojo? Is that what we're depending on? Mojo? Well, what about the stats? The line, the over, the under? What about the odds, the spread, the angle, the handicap? What about the hook, the hot game? You know, the rundown, the system. What about a tout, the trends? What about a wise guy? Everybody needs a wise guy.
Rochelle, I'll have you know I have a very precise system that's worked for 9 months.
Really? What is it?
Every time the Jets win, I use my green toothbrush.
4 out of 5 dentists think she's crazy.
And I pluck 3 mohairs before every game.
And I've been eating 2 chicken fried bananas before every game.
Just 2?
Well, I don't know what you want me to do.
What do you normally do during the game?
Well, other than serving beer and chips, I'm usually ironing.
Did you do that week 2 when the Jets lost?
Now, how am I supposed to know what week is what in your mojo world?
Think, Rochelle, this is important. Remember, I lost all that money. You gave me that lecture on gambling is evil.
That's when Julius burnt my shirt.
Giants win 20-7. Never. Jets lose 20-6.
Julius, my shirt! What do you mean you lost $30? And every week after that, I've been ironing.
And every week? The Jets have been winning, so I don't care what you do on Monday, you make sure you iron those clothes.
Mm-hmm. Before ESPN, people had their own roundtable discussions by sitting around a table and discussing.
So the girls at the beauty shop made a bet against the guys at the barbershop. It's silly, but the guys are rooting for the Giants and the girls are rooting for the Jets.
That is silly. There's no way the Jets are going to continue winning.
Oh, really? What makes you an expert?
Because he's a man.
I watch football every week. That's why I'm an expert.
So you saying I'm stupid?
This was not the first time my parents had this conversation.
It's too expensive.
So you saying I'm not a good mother?
I just don't see what's funny about a Volkswagen Beetle.
So you saying you never should have married me?
That's not what I said.
That's what I said. The Giants are gonna win a Super Bowl, and Phil Simms is gonna lead them to the promised land. Right, Daddy?
That's right, sweetie.
You're crazy. Wesley Walker and Al Tuner are having record years. The Jets are going to the Super Bowl. Ain't that right, Mom?
No doubt about it.
Tanya's right. The Giants are unbeatable.
All right, Julius, I'll tell you what. I hate betting, but since you want to run your mouth and call me names, if the Giants lose before the Jets do, you and Little Miss, that's what I said, have to clean up after everybody else for a month.
And if the Jets lose before the Giants, you and Drew have to do it.
You have a bet.
All right. You're gonna lose.
Since we had gotten off to a bad start, I was praying for a bad finish.
That was so funny when you ran away. You're fast.
You thought that was funny?
You didn't see what it looked like. Besides, that guy didn't scare me.
He didn't?
No, I could see his thumb sticking out of his gun pocket.
Well, didn't he take all your money?
No, he didn't. I keep my money in my bra. All he got were some eye drops and some rash cream.
Eye drops and rash cream? Damn. Little dude owes me $1.
After all I did to make things go wrong, I never would have bet things with Kelly would be going so right.
Well, that was great.
Yeah, it was cool.
Well, I better get home.
Yeah, me too.
Everyone called Kelly Big Bird, but call me Cuckoo. I was actually starting to like her. That kiss from Big Bird made me feel like Superfly. While I was flying with Big Bird, my father wanted the Jets to crash.
I need the Jets to lose.
We doing everything we can to put the mojo on the Jets.
I'm wearing my lucky socks.
I ain't eating up but bananas and peanut butter.
I'm gonna call them up and I'm gonna threaten them.
What about you, Julius? What did you do the last time the Jets lost?
It's weird because I remember I was ironing because the Giants won 20-7 and the Jets lost 20-6. And I remember thinking, that's one extra point worth of loss.
Well, you know what that means. You need to iron on Monday.
Yeah.
Keeping my relationship with Big Bird a secret was easy for the most part. Turns out the person I had the most trouble hiding it from was her. I hid it during school. I hid it before school. I even kept it hidden after school.
What are you looking for, tender love?
The Giants had won their fifth game in a row, and Tanya was counting on the Jets' winning streak to end.
You better pick that up.
I'm not picking it up. You gotta pick it up, and then you're gonna have to clean the rest of the house.
We'll see about that.
Kelly didn't realize that I was avoiding being seen with her. She just thought I was the greatest phone boyfriend ever.
I guess my favorite rappers are Run DMC.
I love Salt and Pepper.
My favorite character from the Rocky movies is Clubber Lang.
I love Captain Drago.
And I jumped off the top stair and started flying and landed on the Mary Jane girls.
I had the exact same dream, except I landed on Rick James.
About the only thing we didn't talk about is when we'd get together again.
So when do you want to do something again?
12th of never?
There's a football game on today. Maybe we could watch that.
My place or yours?
I prefer a secluded town on the outskirts of nowhere.
I was thinking somewhere different.
Where?
Let it be my surprise.
Julius, did you see my...
Hey, Rochelle. You ready for the Jets game?
Those are words you can't say on TV.
Dirty, good for nothing to sneak down here.
What's wrong with you? I'm just doing the ironing.
Oh!
Good thing she wasn't near the toaster.
Lose to Miami, 45.
Yeah!
While my mother was going to kill my father, Nessa was going on a date with Killmoo. I like seeing Kelly, but I made sure to do it when no one I knew would see us.
That was a great game. What made you think of coming to the Port Authority?
Just thought it'd be different.
This is cool. You want to watch something else?
Sure.
Meanwhile, my mother had a giant problem with the Jets losing.
Start cleaning, Drew.
You sit back down, Drew. You're not cleaning up anything.
What are you talking about?
I'm not talking to you. You want to play dirty? Stay dirty.
My father won a bet, but he was about to lose a war. Back at school, the early bird was about to get the worm.
Surprise! I found you.
Kelly, yeah, you did find me. What are you doing here?
I wanted to see you. It's like I never see you around school anymore. It's like I have to hunt you down. I'm almost starting to think that you're trying to avoid me.
Oh, gave you that idea.
You!
I'm just kidding.
Well, you know, I'm kind of busy, so I'll catch you later.
Okay, I get it. No girls in the locker room, right?
Yeah.
Well, I just wanted to give you something before I go.
What's that?
Hey, it's Big Bird.
Hey, where's Bert and Ernie?
I guess that makes you Snuffleupagus?
No, it makes him Roosevelt Franklin.
Cookie?
Cookie!
Who are they making fun of? They obviously watch a lot of Sesame Street.
Chris, aren't you gonna say something? Or are you just gonna stand there and watch?
Stand here and watch.
Fine. Now I know how you really feel.
While I was trying to figure out how to deal with Big Bird, Vanessa was getting prepared to deal with kill moves.
Good evening, ladies.
Kill moves? Where'd you get the car?
I don't know.
Belongs to his mother, Mrs. Devereaux.
Wow, you learn something new every day.
Where's Vanessa?
This is me.
Where's that woman you was just with?
Just explain when you get in the car. Me? Go, go, go. Have a good time, I think.
While Vanessa took care of her end of the bet, at home, all bets were off.
Dinner is served.
Rochelle, this has got to stop.
It never would have started if you never cheated.
Cheated? I never cheated.
Oh, really? So out of the blue, you just decided that you wanted to iron?
Well, no.
You know, good low-down, dirty little...
Whoa. What does me ironing have to do with me cheating?
Because I always do the ironing, and every time I iron, the Jets win. But no, you had to go steal my mojo and ruin our 9-game winning streak.
What? I didn't know ironing was your thing, too. The guys told me to iron again, and I just did it.
Really?
Yeah, I play fair.
Me and Drew will clean upstairs, and you and Tanya will clean downstairs. Don't touch me.
My father made things right with my mother. Now I needed to make things right with my bird.
Hey, Dad, I need to talk to you.
What's up?
Well, there's this girl, and she likes me.
That's good.
And I really like her.
That's better.
Only thing is, she's a little awkward looking.
Awkward? Like she has one leg longer than the other?
No.
Like she dislocated her shoulder and they put it back wrong?
No.
Like her eyes are too far apart?
No.
Like she's knock-kneed and pigeon-toed and when she walks, she makes a clicking sound?
No, it's just that these football players were calling her Big Bird and stuff, and I don't really do anything about it.
Chris, even if a girl's eyes are too far apart, I thought I told you never to hurt a girl's feelings.
I know.
No, obviously you don't.
You think she'll forgive me?
I don't know. You have to work that out with her.
Even if a girl's eyes are too far apart. I realized my mistake, and Vanessa realized that going out with kill moves wasn't a mistake at all.
You were out all night?
Oh, girl, that's just the start of it. We opened the champagne, headed for that seaport. There was a pink helicopter waiting for me.
You can hear about the rest of Vanessa's date at www.vanessasbigdatewithkillmoves.tv. After I gave Big Bird the cold shoulder, I thought she flew the coop.
You haven't seen her?
Nah, dude.
I decided I wasn't gonna let you or anyone else crush me. So my mom took me to the mall for a makeover.
Big Bird, is that you?
My name is not Big Bird, it's Kelly.
I'm sorry about what happened,
It's just you were fine going out with me so long as nobody knew because you didn't want to be Big Bird's boyfriend?
Exactly.
Let me make it up to you. Let me take you out again.
No, never, het, noia.
Unfortunately for me, Kelly spoke 15 languages.
Jo, kua, momo, tla.
Was that Cherokee?
Domo arigato, Mr. Roboto.
What?
Kelly, I was a jerk.
I know. And as much as I'd like to come here every day and make you suffer, I'm going to Paris tomorrow.
Paris?
That's right, Paris. I met a lady at the mall named Cindy Crawford, and she said she's going to turn me into a supermodel.
I'm sorry.
I bet you are. But imagine how sorry you're gonna be when I turn around and walk away. See you later, Kermit.
Tonight's episode was brought to you by the letters D, A, M, and N.
Everybody hates Chris.
Oh, make it broken now.
To do special assignments.
Good morning, everybody.
Some were easy, like Thanksgiving.
Your assignment is to write a report about what you're thankful for.
And Martin Luther King Day.
Your assignment is to write a report about what you would dream about if you were about to be shot.
Some were a lot harder.
This week is my favorite holiday, Earth Day. Or as you would say, Chris, Earth Day.
If you live on Earth, isn't every day Earth Day?
What's Earth Day?
Well, Chris, people are destroying the planet with things like plastic bags and cans, bottles, and indestructible foodstuffs. On Earth Day, we put forth our best efforts to save the planet.
I thought saving the planet was a waste of time because I was too busy trying to save me. I tried saving my face. I tried saving my ass. I even tried saving my future kids' ass. To this day, I love geography.
Your assignment is to do something you think will help save the Earth. Craig.
You mean something like building a solar-powered tanning bed?
Isn't that what the beach is?
That's very good, Craig. Chris, what would you like to do?
I knew my dad had a truck, and Bed-Stuy was a mess, so I had the perfect project.
Collect cans and recycle them?
That's wonderful. Then you could take the money and do something for the environment. You could plant a tree.
Maybe I could plant my foot in your body. My father helped me with my Earth Day project seemed like a great idea until he found out about it.
Earth Day?
It's the day where we try to save the Earth. I have a project to do, too.
Earth Day must not be too important if I still gotta go to work. A lot of banks closed. You still gotta feed the parking meters. And what are you doing to save the Earth?
I'm recycling cans, and the money I make I'm gonna use to help the environment.
Just like Bono.
Oh, no, Chris. Sounds like it might take too much time.
Julius, your son is trying to save the Earth. Are you gonna help him or not?
My father had been asked that question before, and there was only one right answer. Whether it was something minor...
Are you gonna do the dishes or not?
Or something major.
Are you gonna propose to me or not?
There you go, baby.
Oh, thank you! Oh, mwah, see?
Sure, I'll help you out. It's your first can. I hope you get an A.
Thanks, Dad.
What are you doing, boy?
I have to build a car out of this piece of wood.
I want to know what you're doing with my potatoes.
That's how I'm going to power it. It's environmentally friendly.
And you wasting my potatoes is butt-whipping friendly.
Wait till he finds out Drew's making the engine out of steak.
Listen to this. Dear parent, your daughter Tanya has been cited for a conduct violation and your presence is being requested for a conference.
What kind of conduct violation?
She said I was being rude and belligerent.
Ain't no damn body rude and belligerent. I'ma go down there and show them what rude and belligerent is.
No kidding.
Rude and belligerent.
While I had my father on my side, my mother was going to get a teacher off of Tanya's back.
I don't see why I had to take a whole day off of work to come down here for this nonsense.
I don't think it's nonsense. Tanya was exhibiting some aggressive behavior toward a classmate. I just wanted you to be aware of it.
I was just trying to read and she wouldn't be quiet.
Girl, you interrupt me again, I'm gonna knock the sound out of your mouth. How is she being aggressive?
Apparently, Tanya turned toward her study partner and said this.
You'll get to hear it on the unrated DVD.
Did you say this?
Sorta.
Well, she was trying to study, right?
That's not the point.
Oh, I think it is.
This is school, and her behavior will not be tolerated.
Her behavior? What about the other little girl's behavior? Why don't you have her mother come down here and tell her kid to shut up while my baby is trying to study?
That's neither here nor there.
Then please, where is it?
What I'd like to ask is, do you know where Tanya got this language from?
My mother had two answers to that question. Answer A.
She got it from this knot I'm about to put upside your head.
And answer B.
Well, I don't know, but it won't happen again. Have a nice day. Tanya, come on.
I want to get transferred.
Girl, don't backtalk me right now. Now is not the time.
At Doc's, I was setting out on my master plan.
If you want to save the Earth, you better figure out what to do about them Russians. They got bombs. My whole family worked in the fields. I hate fields. I love concrete. You can't grow cotton on concrete.
I help the environment by driving as much as I can. You ever ride that train? That train is filthy, man. You know it's dirty as hell. When rats got footies on. You want to save this planet? Get rid of them trains. Get rid of them trains.
I help the environment by wearing wigs. People put a whole lot of chemicals in their hair. Then they wash it out, goes right into the river. People gotta drink that water. When you're done with a wig, just flush it down the toilet. If it ends up in your glass, well, at least you can see it.
I can't believe this is not margarine. It tastes real great. Plus, it has pardry, dryly, margarine, hydra, glycerin. That saves cows.
If the Earth died, that would be tragic. But I sure like to sell that coffin.
So how'd it go with Tanya?
That teacher's crazy. That's how it went.
What happened?
I was trying to study and this girl kept talking, so I told her,
if you don't shut up, I'ma slap the chatter out of you.
And she left me alone.
Wow, you sound just like Mom.
No, she doesn't.
She does. I mean, just a little.
So you think that this is my fault?
Well, you do kind of always yell.
Okay, then fine, I'll stop. What? That's funny?
Yes.
You're gonna stop yelling?
Yes, I'm gonna stop yelling. You just watch.
I got $5 says you won't last a week.
Bet. My money's on him. My father had promised to help me collect cans, but all he was collecting was some shut-eye.
Dad.
Shh.
You think we can go out and get started?
Started on what?
Collecting cans.
What cans?
For my project.
What project?
My school project.
What school project?
Collecting cans.
Chris, I'm tired. Can't you do it yourself?
Yeah, I guess I can start by myself.
A kid collecting cans with his dad is recycling. A kid collecting cans by himself is bum practice.
Dad.
Well, Earth, it's just us. Since my dad wouldn't help me, it looked like I'd have to save the Earth all on my own. Unfortunately, you could turn in cans for money, and every bum in Bed-Stuy knew it. They may be bums, but they're not lazy bums.
Hey, Chris.
What are you doing in there?
Collecting cans, turning enough, get a lot of cans, plus good for the environment. What are you doing, soldier?
I'm trying to collect cans, too. It's for my Earth Day project.
Want to collect cans around here? Gotta be quick.
Yeah, I guess so.
Gotta be quicker than that.
And not mind sitting in garbage. after a few days, I could see that my recycling project was no can do.
You gotta be quick to get the cans. That's a big business. I thought my dad was gonna be helping me. This was supposed to be easy. Maybe you should switch projects. Yeah, now all I have to do is come up with a solar-powered excuse. I'd help you, but I ran into a major problem.
What happened?
While I was making my tanning bed, I accidentally invented an incandescent light bulb that won't burn out for 600 years.
That's amazing. Then you'll definitely get an A.
I can't turn that in.
Why not?
Are you crazy? I'd be a marked man. I'm not taking down every major power company in the nation. You'd have me killed in a minute. So I decided to switch projects. I'm going with a dung-powered radar system.
U.S. patent number D349127.
So what are you gonna do?
Well, I figured there's a bunch of cans around here somewhere. I might as well just keep looking.
See these two little cup-like things?
Mm-hmm.
But yes. Potatoes. Take one of these little electrodes and plunge it into the potato there. And take the other one and plunge it into the other potato.
Back at home, my mother needed help, too.
Drew, what is all this stuff on the table? Boy, you better clean this table before I knock
you. Are you yelling?
Electrodes.
No.
A piece of wire like that. So I want you to, this one you put a
sweetie,
in, that one you put a zinc.
When you get a chance, would you mind putting this stuff away so I can set the table for dinner?
Yeah, I'll do it in a minute.
Hi, Tanya. Did Daddy say you can have ice cream before dinner?
Nope, but I got hungry.
But, Tanya, it's almost dinner time. I don't want you to ruin your
Mama,
appetite.
Don't worry about it. I'm going to eat my dinner.
This is like watching a volcano almost erupt. Outside calm, inside furious.
Tanya, why are you reading at the table? Why aren't you eating your dinner?
I'm just not hungry.
Well, maybe it's all that ice cream you had before dinner.
Yep, maybe.
Who said you could eat ice cream before dinner?
Nobody.
That's the problem.
What?
Nothing. So, Chris, how's your project coming along?
Okay. Me and Dad are just trying to figure out a time that's good for us to go looking for cans.
Yeah, we're working on the time.
Oh, okay, that's nice. I'm sure you two will work it out.
I'm not.
Well, I finally figured out my project.
I hope you figure out how to clean that mess up.
I built a potato clock. Now all I have to do is paint it.
Paint? On my dining room table?
Mm-hmm.
I know you don't. You're not getting me. I'm keeping that $5. Paint all you want. Paint 20 potatoes if you have to, Drew.
Are those my good potatoes?
Not anymore.
Yeah, but I'll chop them up and make french fries after I turn my project in. Hey, check it out. I put a calendar on the front.
I thought you were supposed to be making the car.
I thought you were supposed to be eating your dinner.
I was, but the potatoes were too weak to run it.
I wonder how many potatoes we need to get rid of the light bill.
Enough to make mashed potatoes for the next million years.
So, Dad, you think you can pick me up after school tomorrow?
For what?
To pick up cans.
Yeah. Yeah, cans. No problem. Work tomorrow. No problem.
Unfortunately for me, if you offered my dad a job, he forgot about everything else.
So, Dad, I'm gonna come straight home after school tomorrow, okay?
Oh, I'm sorry, Chris. I just picked up an extra shift. I get paid time and a half, but hey, you doing okay, though, right?
Yeah, Dad, I'm fine.
All right, I knew you would. You man, that's my boy.
We learned the reason my mother yelled wasn't because she liked yelling. It was because if she didn't yell, no one would hear her.
Drew, wake up.
Hey.
Chris, you gonna be late.
I'm coming.
Okay, fine. Don't go to school. Grow up stupid. Tanya, wake up, baby.
All right. 5 more minutes.
See? This is what I'm talking about. I try to be nice, and this is the thanks I get. Yeah, I try not to be rude and belligerent. If I wasn't, nothing would get done around here. But that's okay. Oh, okay, I guess I'm supposed to clean this up, too. Oh, no problem, Mr. Potato. I'll clean you up. I have nothing else better to do. No, please, you sit right there. I'll be back. No, really, stay. No, it's okay. It's okay, because...
Uh-oh.
Now that is just nasty.
After searching around, I found a few cans, but what I really needed was some help.
There he is, officer. That's the man.
Hold it right there. Stop.
That's my boy.
If I ever needed my dad's help, I needed it then.
Dad! Dad!
Oh, dang it.
Wait! Dad?
I'm not your daddy. Am I?
No.
Thank you, God.
To get cans to recycle, first I had to cycle them.
Hey, baby, what you doing?
I looked everywhere and I couldn't find any cans, so I figured I'd get my own. You want a soda?
Yeah, thanks. You mean to tell me you and your daddy couldn't find one can?
I didn't want to tell on my dad, but I didn't want to lie.
Well, Dad hasn't really had any time to come looking for cans with me. He's been working.
Really?
My project was on its last leg, and for my mother, that was the last straw.
Julius, wake up!
Whoa, what's going on? What?
I thought you were going to help Chris with his homework.
I was. I am.
When?
I've been working.
Oh, and I've just been laying around the house all day? Is that what it is? I asked you to help that boy with one homework assignment in what, 15 years? And you can't even do that! All I ask you to do is take the boy and pick up some cans.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. You ought to be! Your son needed your help with one school assignment, but no, you were too busy.
But baby...
But what? Are you gonna help him or not? That's exactly what I thought. Take your money. I'm back!
After school, I was in for a big surprise.
Dad? What's wrong? What happened?
Oh, calm down. I'm here to help you with your Earth Day project.
I thought you had to work.
I do. Now let's go get these cans. It's pretty full.
Yeah, so you want to take it to the recycling center?
No, let's take it first thing in the morning.
Yeah.
Tanya, I know you heard me scream yesterday.
Yeah? Are you sorry?
No, I'm not sorry. And I'll tell you why. You can only talk that way to someone when you love them. But you have to be nice to the people that you don't know.
But that doesn't make any sense.
No, it doesn't make any sense. But it so happens to be true.
Like when Bush got reelected.
But how can it be true if it doesn't make any sense?
Because that's just the way the truth is.
Oh.
So this means that I'm gonna go back to yelling at everybody.
Because you love us.
Exactly.
So I can yell at you too.
If you want the feelings knocked out of your face, go right ahead.
I'd collected cans, and now it was time to cash in.
So you had to miss work for this, Dad.
That's okay. So how much money did you make? $100? $200?
Six.
$600?
No, $6. I mean, I can't do anything with this. How am I supposed to save the Earth with $6?
You know what, Chris? To some people, $6 is a lot of money. You said you wanted to help the planet.
I just hope he knows this is cash, not a salad.
Hey, Kim Moose.
I need you up.
Hey, Chris.
Yeah, I got something for you.
What's this for?
Earth Day.
Earth Day, huh? Thanks.
Hey,
happy Earth Day.
Let's get you to school.
People talk about saving the planet by picking up cans and bottles, but the one thing I learned from Earth Day was that saving the planet meant a lot to me, but doing it with my father meant the world to me.
So, Chris, tell us about your Earth Day project.
Oh, well, me and my dad collected a truck full of cans.
Chris, that's wonderful.
And I gave the money to someone less fortunate. I mean, there's no reason to save the Earth if you can't save the people.
Oh, Chris, that's so profound. Other than the fact that you can see, Stevie Wonder's got nothing on you. I know in my heart that money is somehow going to help us all.
So we have 13 styrofoam ice chests, 4 cans of aerosol spray paint, 1 pack of cigarettes, a gallon of whiskey, and 1 container of I can't believe it's not margarine. Would that be paper or plastic?
Plastic.
Happy Earth Day! I've been working at Doc's for 3 years. Outside of getting robbed 4 times, sick on the pickles 3 times, and a double hernia, it was the single greatest job I ever had. And from time to time, a pretty girl might stroll in. In exchange for all my hard work, I got paid $3 an hour.
Good job, man. $60. Cold, hard cash.
I had the perfect job until I found out about minimum wage. Basically, minimum wage is the only guarantee people get paid in money. Your boss would pay you in popsicle sticks if he could.
Great work.
A popsicle stick? Oh, you take this thing for man. I cannot work. I live off no popsicle sticks. At least you can't do is give me the damn popsicle.
Minimum wage. There was a time when the maximum wage for black folks was zero.
But now the government requires that you pay me $3.35 an hour.
Well, work for the government. Look, Chris, I like having you around, and you do a good job. But I just can't spare the money.
It's only 35 cents more an hour.
35 cents an hour. That's $28 a month. That's 3 cartons of milk a day. That's 2 boxes of Mike and Ike an hour. That's no.
That's when I realized I'd found the one person cheaper than my father. I thought about picketing, but I was afraid this would happen. I thought about a sit-in, but I was afraid this would happen again. But I decided on an ultimatum.
Doc, listen, I come in on time, and I never leave early. I work hard, so I deserve minimum wage. And if you're not gonna give me a raise, I'm gonna have to leave. It's a matter of principles.
Is that an ultimatum?
Well, is it?
Yeah.
Nice working with you.
You'd really let me go? Where else are you gonna find somebody as reliable and trustworthy as I am that'll work for $60 a week?
Sir, are you hiring?
Well, am I?
Are you?
Depends.
You gonna pay me?
Nope.
Then yes, because I quit.
Maybe I should have gotten Al Sharpton involved. Tried to get minimum wage while my father tried to get minimum sleep.
Guess what? Vanessa asked me to be her hair model for the upcoming hair show.
By Vanessa asked, she meant I beg.
Please, 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 please let me be your hair model.
Fine. Pull yourself together.
Hair show, huh?
Yes.
Does it pay?
Well, it pays $100, but I'm not doing it for the money. You know, it's always been a dream of mine to be a hair model. Julius, I could just see myself walking down that runway.
I said you better give me my money, fool.
At dinner, Drew looks sadder than 69 cent shoes.
Hey, Drew. What's wrong?
I failed my history test.
Told you sleeping in a room with Chris would make you stupid.
Tanya, hush. What happened, baby?
I studied, but when I sat down, my mind went blank.
Your mind went blank? What kind of excuse is that? Did you eat breakfast?
Yes.
Well, did you get a good night's sleep?
Yes.
Well, boy, did you hit your head on a stupid rock on the way to school?
No.
Well, I'm gonna help you study for that next test, because I didn't raise no dummies.
Bush's mom says that, too.
How was work, Chris?
Huh?
How's work?
It was fine.
Good. I told Doc I said hi. He's a good guy.
Yeah, he's great.
If I develop the drug problem, my next job might be president.
You quit?
Yeah, now I have to find another job. I can't tell my dad I quit my job. He'll kill me. Got a couple things circled to check out. Greg!
What?
You're drooling.
It's Mandy. She's so hot.
She's all right. Plus, you've been saying that for the past month. Why don't you just go talk to her?
I can't just walk up to her and start talking.
Works for pimps.
Yeah, you can.
Okay, smarty pants. Do I say hi? Do I say hello? Or maybe hey? Or even hey hi? The possibilities are endless. We haven't even gotten to what I'll be wearing.
I know what you'll be wearing. A look of frozen terror. I wasn't getting paid, and Greg was afraid.
Oh, girl, I am so excited. So what styles do you have in mind?
Well, let me tell you about my follicular extravaganza.
Girl, check out Vanessa's designs.
Ooh, my goodness. Oh, who did these drawings?
Girl, my cousin Dante.
He's taking an art class in prison.
They are so cute. I could just picture myself in all of them.
My mother imagined herself in the Eiffel Tower, the helicopter, and the black smacker.
Oh! I've decided to go with the one that is the most difficult technique-wise. The tsunami.
Whoa! You know what? I heard the last hairdresser who tried the tsunami died.
No, actually, the hairdresser was fine. It was the model that died.
What? Mm-hmm. Hairspray poison.
Wait a minute. What's this one?
Girl, that's the upside-down cruise ship. You know, the Poseidon Adventure.
Oh, yeah, but we're not gonna do that one. You know how hard it is to get 1,500 tiny little people made out of hair? It's a mess.
Wait a minute. I heard Jacques Leblanc is competing.
This is a long, dramatic story about backstabbing hairdressers that we've heard before. So we're going to move on. While my mother got a dye job, I went to get a job. This was the first restaurant in Bed-Stuy without a bulletproof window. There was the bulletproof fish plate. Then the bulletproof salad bar. And the bulletproof hot dog stand.
Hey, man, can I get number 2, please?
When can you start?
Tomorrow after school.
You're hired.
The
Job pays minimum wage and all the rice you can eat.
I'll take it.
Listen closely and you'll learn how to say the N-word in Chinese.
Now focus, boy.
Hey, Ma. Hey, Dad.
Chris, where you been? You were supposed to be back an hour ago.
I was out selling crack.
Not all my early attempts at comedy were a success.
Just kidding. I was out looking for work. I found a job working at Who's Who Now.
Who's on first?
I like walks on second.
Well, what happened to Docs?
He refused to pay me minimum wage, so I found a job that would.
Minimum wage? I paid a man to let me work my first job. The kid's got it good.
It's about the principle, Dad, not the money. I work hard, and if the man says I should get paid $3.35, then he should pay me.
Well, good luck with that.
You get free Chinese food?
Yeah, all the rice I want.
I like those principles.
Good, because I ain't cooking till after the hair show.
The next day, I got $3.35 worth of new job.
Momo, none of Richie.
About as much as you look like Yoko Ono.
You're late.
No, I'm not. It's 3 o'clock.
It's 3:01. Now, get to work.
No matter what I did, it seemed like I was supposed to be doing something else.
Bye.
Hi, Chia.
When I washed the floors.
I know, Richie. Set the tables.
When I set the table.
I know. Organize the fortune cookies.
When I organize the fortune cookies.
Bye, Saudi, Lionel Richie. Go wash the dishes.
You wouldn't talk to the real Lionel Richie like that.
What?
Keep on working.
I was lucky Mr. Fong wasn't zoned to grow cotton.
See,
What are you doing?
Oh, I finished the dishes, so I decided to start my homework.
No homework. You have work.
But Doc always let me start my homework.
Well, you are not a Doc's anymore. Go fix the menu numbers.
I was getting minimum wage and having minimum fun. My new job wasn't just making me tired of working. It was making me tired of Greg.
Hey, man, you look terrible.
I know. I work more at Who's in the day than I do at Doc's in a month.
There's Mandy. I've decided to go with Hey. I can't figure out what I'm gonna do with my hair, though. Should I part it to the side or go straight back?
Shave it off and start over.
Chris, wake up. I'm trying to tell you something.
What?
I've been having a hard time with my Mandy situation. This girl could be my future ex-wife, and I don't want to mess it up.
Greg still isn't over his parents' divorce.
It's not a real problem. You think you're having a hard time? You've got an obvious solution. Let me help you. Hey, Mandy. Greg wants to talk to you.
Who's Greg?
Him. There, how's that?
You're embarrassing me. And when it comes to embarrassing myself in front of girls, I don't need any help.
I don't know. I think she kind of liked him.
Ta-da! Well, what do you think? Now remember, don't move it.
Don't touch it.
Don't stick anything in it.
Don't scratch it.
Don't move your eyebrows.
Don't shower.
Don't bathe.
Wash up.
And most important of all, don't lie down.
Well, how am I supposed to sleep?
You're not supposed to sleep. You're a hair model.
Well, models sleep. They don't eat.
Not hair models.
They eat, not sleep.
Everybody gather round. Look at me. Look at me.
While a team of people worked on my mother's hair, I did the work of a team.
He who sleeps at work wakes up with the foot in the ass.
I wasn't sleeping, I was breathing.
Well, breathe while you work.
Mr. Fong, can I ask you a question?
All talk and no work makes Chris unemployed.
Well, I embarrassed my friend Greg in front of a girl, and now he won't talk to me. What should I do?
Here.
Get back to work.
Now, hand out these delivery menus.
People found the idea of getting food delivered in Bed-Stuy unbelievable.
Delivery in Bed-Stuy. Unbelievable.
Delivery? In this neighborhood? Man, you crazy. I got kids over here I don't visit.
So how's it going out there, Chris? They're not working you too hard, are they?
No, it's great. Mr. Fong's cool. So how's it going here?
Good.
Good? So, it's not too hard, you know, working over here by yourself.
Hey, Chris.
James, what are you doing here?
I work here. You think I'm just walking around in an apron carrying boxes for nothing? I'm trying to make some extra money. Man, there must be something wrong with you. This is a good job. Sure glad you quit. And tell Tanya I'm holding aside the bubble gum she likes.
You're gonna be holding your teeth if you go near my sister.
You failed the test again? But we studied this, boy. What happened?
I don't know. My brain froze.
Well, you better thaw it out.
My teacher says she wants a parent to come in.
Will your father go with you tomorrow?
Why can't you go?
I can't go with this hair. I don't want those people to think I'm some no-count hair model. Here.
If Drew didn't get it together quick, he was going to be lost at sea. Delivering in Bed-Stuy was an adventure.
Who is it?
Who's?
Who's what?
Who's delivering?
Who? I don't know.
Man, it's Chinese food.
Oh.
Thank you. Chinese food.
Oh, don't worry, because it's your last supper. I saw you with her. Didn't you see him, baby? Everybody did. You must think I'm stupid or blind. Maybe you think I'm stupid and blind. How much is it, baby? But one thing I promise you, you ain't gonna have to think much longer. He must think I'm crazy. He must, baby, baby, where you at? Oh, no, don't move. Don't move.
Lionel Richie, you're back just in time for another delivery.
I'm not going back out there. This neighborhood is too dangerous for deliveries. You basically send me out there with a sign saying, hey, I got money, please rob me. Plus, I almost got shot.
My nephew has been shot by the Chinese army 7 times.
Those are that tall.
He should stop attacking China.
Here's your check. Maybe it'll help you feel better.
$48.29. What's the rest of the money?
Taxes. The law says I have to take out withholding. Welcome to America. Now take this to Decatur Street.
You take it. Because I quit. And I don't look like Lionel Richie.
Yes, I do.
Hey, Dad.
Hey, Chris. How's the new job working out?
I quit.
You quit? Quitting is for smoking and drinking. You better have a good reason for quitting your job.
Mr. Fong kept yelling at me. I almost got shot at. I got robbed. I'm getting sick of rice. And to top that all off, I'm getting paid way much less than I was before.
You know what, Chris? You quit Docs for your principles. He was a good boss, but you picked minimum wage over good working conditions. It looks like you picked the wrong principle to stand on.
Yeah, I did.
Well, what you gonna do now?
I'm gonna go out and find another job.
That's not it, Chris. Look, you just can't quit every time you don't like something. I mean, what if Miles Davis quit the trumpet?
Yeah, I know. What if George Washington Carver quit the peanut? What if B.B. King quit Lucille? What if Paul Robeson quit Old Man River? What if Bill Cosby quit Jell-O? What if Mr. T quit Pity and the Fool? What if Stevie quit Wondering? What if Fat Albert quit the Cosby Kids? What if Ashford quit Simpson? What if Michael Jackson quit doing the moonwalk? What if Diana Ross quit the Supreme?
Diana Ross did quit the Supreme.
You get my point.
Just go get a job.
Okay.
Later, my mother's tsunami came crashing down in waves. Here today, on the mark.
Oh, hey, girl.
The tsunami turned into Hurricane Rochelle.
What happened to my hair? What happened to my hair? All my work? What did you do? What did you do? What am I supposed to do with a head full of broken hair?
What am I gonna do about the show?
Oh, God, the show!
No,
forget the show! Julius is never gonna sleep with me.
My mother's career as a hair model was over faster than Pac-Man Jones' career as a citizen. My father went to get to the bottom of Drew's problem, which was actually where the problem started.
Is that Miss Crabtree?
Yep, that's her.
My father took one look at Miss Crabtree and knew exactly why Drew was failing.
Excuse me, can I help you? Hi, Drew.
Hi.
Is all that really necessary?
I'm sorry, all of what?
all this? I mean, the boy can't even concentrate.
Neither can you.
I'm sorry, I still don't follow.
Excuse me. Drew, what's 8 times 12?
I don't know.
How about now?
96.
Who wrote the Declaration of Independence?
I don't know.
How about now?
Thomas Jefferson.
Drew, what's your name?
I don't know.
Look, if you are gonna be an educator, buy some uglier clothes, please. Come on.
Drew's grades improved after he transferred to the class of Miss Murphy, a 90-year-old lady with a mustache.
Alrighty, class, so today we're gonna learn about the Mexican-American War. What do we know about the Mexican-American War? Anybody?
We know we'd like to take you out for Mexican food.
Nobody?
Hey, Greg.
I didn't know what to say to Greg, so I imagined what Doc would say.
Chris, you need to tell your friend you're sorry.
Why? He's the one with the problem. All I did was try to help. I'm talking to Mandy.
You got him to feel like an idiot.
He is an idiot. All he had to do was say hi.
Look, Chris, a man can't say hi or goodbye to a woman unless he's ready to do it on his own. And you got him to talk to Mandy. Now you gotta get him to talk to you.
Hey, man, listen, I'm sorry for embarrassing you in front of Mandy.
What the heck? It's not like I have other friends to hang out with.
So we're cool?
Yeah.
We were friends, but we were far from cool.
Took the points. Oh, I can't believe the Knicks lost that game last night.
Hey, Doc.
Hey. Good to see you, Chris.
Just coming by to say I'm sorry.
Well, sorry for what?
For quitting my job. I mean, I didn't know how good I had it.
Look, Chris. If I paid you minimum wage, you'd get taxed and I'd get taxed. I'd have to get unemployment insurance, workman's compensation, and there are child labor laws. Look, the bottom line is, if I paid you minimum wage, I'd have to close up the store.
Years later, Doc closed the store and opened a Walmart.
Well, thanks. We'll see.
Don't wait, Chris. No, if you want your job back, it's yours.
What about James?
He quit.
Here you go, Doc.
You're working at Who's now?
Yeah, man. That's a good job. I don't know why you quit. He pays $67 a week, cash, no taxes. Must be something wrong with you.
I'd like to kick him in the fortune cookies. Everybody.